Good morning friends, I am Ankit Kumar Sahu Rajveer and today we are going to study about the great dramatist of Elizabethan and Jacobean era. He is absolutely William Shakespeare. So before coming to the topic, I would like to request you, if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel so that I could be motivated by you. So let's start the study of the dramatist or the poet. William Shakespeare is the most famous writer of all time. In his 52 years of life, Shakespeare produced 38 plays, 154 sonnets, and various verses and narrative poems. His name is known to even the most undereducated person, and most of his plays and themes still resonate in today's mainstream society. Despite the fact that Shakespeare's plays were written in the 60s, they are still performed and beloved by audiences and have been translated into practically every language. William Shakespeare was born in Stratford-upon-Avon, Warwickshire, England. While his exact date of birth is unknown, church records confirm that he was baptized on April 26, 1564. Shakespeare was from a somewhat prominent family. His father, John Shakespeare, was an alderman, a member of political council, and his mother, Mary Arden Shakespeare, was the daughter of an affluent landlord farmer. William was the third child of eight and oldest surviving son. As a child of means, Shakespeare had access to good education via the King's New School. In 1582, at 18 years of age, Shakespeare married a woman named Anne Hathaway, who was approximately 8 years his senior. Anne and Shakespeare went on to have three children, Susanna, twins named Hamnet and Judith. Sadly, Hamnet died when he was only 11, most likely of the plague. Between the year of 1585 and 1592, Shakespeare started to gain a favorable reputation in London theatre circle, where he worked as an actor, writer, and later the co-owner of a theatre company called Lord Chamberlain's Man. The name was later changed to King's Man. Shakespeare was known for his versatility as a writer. He penned comedies, tragedies, and even some historical pieces. 1689 and 1630 are regarded as Shakespeare's golden years. 1689 and 1630 are regarded as Shakespeare's golden years, when he did the largest bulk of his writing. Despite the success of his plays and household name status, little is known about the private life of William Shakespeare. However, there are documents which suggest that he retired to Stratford, England in 1638 as age 49. He died there 3 years later on April 23, 1660 of an unspecified illness. He was only 52 years old. Despite the fact that William Shakespeare lived a relatively short time, the influence of his plays has left a lasting impact on society that has persisted until this day. His intricate plots, complicated characters, genre-melding techniques, and beautifully worded dialect inspired myriads of later writers to expand their literary horizon. In the 80s, Charles Dickens declared Shakespeare's works to have been a huge influence on his own. The themes that run through Shakespeare's plays, love, hate, anger, happiness, humor, depression, etc., still resonate with modern audiences, and his work is performed more than those of any other playwright in the world. In fact, Shakespeare is standard reading in most high school and college curriculum. William Shakespeare's imagination spawned literary works that have continued to thrive more than 400 years after the death of their creator. That is certainly a reason to become familiar with this literature. So, this was all about Shakespeare. And in my next lecture, I would like to deliver lecture on the Hamlet. Thank you.